From New York City, it's time to play the Match Game. This portion of the Match Game brought to you today by Downy, the fabric softener that bathes in deep downy softness and extra whiteness, too. And now, here's your host, Gene Rayburn.
Hello! Thank you very much. Here we go again. Listen, we had so much excitement going here at the end of yesterday's show, I didn't have time to give the score, and I think I ought to do that right now. Ladies, on behalf of the Girl Scouts of America, you won a total of $200 for them. Well, we congratulate you. And gentlemen, on behalf of the Boy Scouts of America, you won a total of $350. Now, there we go. Now, to those of you who weren't here at your television sets yesterday, we're playing all week long with these two all-star teams, and let's officially meet them right now. Playing on the ladies' team, Peggy Cass, Betty White, and Joan Fontaine. And over on the other side, we have Bennett Cerf, and Henry Morgan, and Robert Q. Lewis. Good luck to you, ladies and gentlemen. Now let's play. This is the way it works. I ask a question to which there are many possible answers, number of good ones anyway, and we ask these people to use their judgment and write down the answer they think is most likely to match their teammates. Remember, the ladies are playing for the Girl Scouts, and the gentlemen are playing for the Boy Scouts. First question, please. Name something you buy that might turn out to be a lemon. Something you buy that might turn out to be a lemon. You name the thing you think your teammates will name. In a moment, we'll check. Question number one here, name something you might buy that might turn out to be a lemon. Let's begin with the ladies and check their answers. Peggy, would you hold your card up, please?
In car.
A car, she has. Betty, what is your answer?
Car.
Car, there's a man. Joan, what have you got there?
I'm more literal, lime.
A lime. Okay. Name something you might turn out to be a lemon. I gotta figure that one out there. Name something you might turn out to be a lemon. It could be a lime. Well, you bought a lemon or a lime or what? How do I know? All right, let's check the gentleman's answers now. Bennett, what have you got?
Well, I had automobile, which I guess is the same
automobile
as car.
Automobile is the same as car. Hold it up there, Bennett, until we finish calling on your team all across.
But somebody ought to say a word in Joan's defense, and I would like to.
All right.
Actually, she's quite right. You buy a lime, and it could turn out to be a lemon.
That's right.
When they're both green, they're very... Thank you. Automobile.
Thank you. Automobile is a lemon. That's true. There are several interpretations of this question, and you just have to listen carefully and be on the... Oh, Robert Q., what do you
say? I'd like to say a word in Henry's defense.
I said car.
Car is a match on the car. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now complete this sentence with the amount you think your teammates will write down. To a rich man, blank dollars is nothing. To a rich man, blank dollars is nothing.
A cheap rich man or an extravagant
rich man? Is there such a thing? A cheap rich man. Interesting question, which I will not answer. This will be interesting. Mm-hmm. Okay, hands down. Peggy Cass.
$100.
To a rich man, $100 is nothing. A mere bagatelle. Betty White, what do you say?
I've been with cheaper rich men than you, $5.
$5.
I know some rich men 10 cents a day.
Joan, what is your answer?
Well, I've heard of poor millionaires, but I said $100.
$100 is an F. Well, we're up to 50 points now.
Oh, boy.
Bennett, what do you say?
I believe in thinking very big, and I have $1 million.
Ooh, to a rich man, $1 million is nothing.
Nothing?
Bennett is a very wealthy man, I forgot to point out.
I'd like to meet your friend.
I wasn't thinking of myself.
Henry?
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Boy, is he wealthy.
I know this little punk here at $1,000.
$1,000.
Nothing. A biker, man.
Oh, well, boy. Bob, it's up to you to break this tie if you can.
I have known what I consider to be rich men, and to them, $1 million is nothing.
Oh, it's a mess. You know, I think you could have gotten odds of a million to one that would not have been a match, $1 million. But it was, and the men are now ahead, yes?
I was this far from saying a million.
You were that far.
Yeah,
would you
but
close
the question
it in,
is,
please?
Yes, but the question is, who do these girls know?
Yeah.
I've never met a sport like you.
Peggy said, I never met a sport like you.
I was thinking about, I was thinking of the people who do all these shows, Goodson Todman.
I see. I will refrain from any comment on that announcement. Now, here's your next question. Write down the one word you think is used most often when you talk. Write down the one word you think is used most often when you talk. This is nice. All right, we're going to check your syntax now, and we'll begin with Peggy.
I.
All right, Betty, what did you say?
It may be cheating. I was going to say and, but then I said I.
I is a man. Well, I don't think I could have won with you ladies. I was thinking of T-H-E, the. Well, Joan, what have you got?
I'm an egotist, too.
I am in a purple ground. All right, gentlemen, one match from you will tie the score. Two, however, will win it. None, and they win. Bennett.
Oh, I was thinking of the girls, and I said yes.
Yes.
Oh!
Henry, may we see your card?
Oh.
I. All right, Robert Q., you've got a match. Yes or I, or the ladies will win.
Congratulations. What you said.
He matched me, but the ladies win the game. Very good, ladies. Very good. All right, get ready for the audience match, but first this. Here's some good advice for do-it-yourselfers. You watch this. All right, ladies, ready for the audience match? Okay. Now, we have three questions in the group here that was asked of a studio audience during the week of December 23rd. And let's get to them. It's $50 every time you match the answer given most often. We asked 50 men in that studio audience this question. How many times a year do you buy your wife a little present for no special reason? Now remember, we asked it of 50 men as a little departure from the regular style we play here.
50 big
but you think it over now. And no writing, remember. And Peggy, you're first. What answer do we get most often from those 50 men?
Twice. We know the same man.
Betty, what do you think the 50 men said?
What they said or what they did?
Well,
what they said.
What they said.
I think they said three.
Three times. And Joan?
I'll go six.
Six times. How many times a year do you buy your wife a little present for no special reason? We have two, three, six. Turn around, ladies. Here is what the gentleman said. None.
I know all 50
truth?
Of those men.
Those men were honest, truthful, loyal...
Cheapskates.
Right.
Cheese.
All right. None. No match there, sorry to say. How much... then we asked 50 women in the studio audience this question. 50 women. How much money should a woman spend for a hat? Now, Peggy, you tell us what... response we got most often from the 50 women who were asked that question.
$15.
$15, Betty?
$20.
$20, Joan?
20.
Two 20s and a 15. The answer from those 50 women was $10.
$10. Well, I don't think you're buying two hats.
Talk about honesty among men and women there. I don't want to say the women appear to be less honest, but there. All right, third and last one. We asked 50 men in the studio audience to complete this phrase. An attractive woman has blank hair. An attractive woman has blank hair. All right, Peggy, in your judgment, how did the 50 men in the studio audience complete that phrase?
Lots of... Blonde.
Blonde hair, Betty? Miss Brunette of 1964.
What kind of mousy brown. No, I'll say blonde.
Blonde. Joan?
Blonde.
Blonde. All three of you say blonde, the gentleman said. Blonde! Henry, you have a question?
No, I have a complaint, and this is as good a time to get rid of it as any.
Yeah.
Has this thing been going on for all this time about blonde, 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 blonde? Are we going to end up a country of all little dyed ladies? What's the matter? Are brunettes really...
Well, that's all I had in mind.
That's all he wanted.
He just wanted Betty White to get up and go over there and give him a little kiss, and that's all. And now he feels loved and secure. I'm sorry, Peggy, I didn't hear.
I said I am a big dyed lady.
Yeah, little dyed lady versus big dyed lady.
Does she or doesn't she?
She admits she does.
There's her campaign now that only blondes have fun, and they show a poor little nice-looking brunette girl sulking around, and she's having a terrible time.
Poor.
Well, there's a mistake here. That brunette could have a ball. She has to know one of us or... you, and you've got a pretty good-looking...
Hello
you've
there,
got two
America.
Good-looking ones at home.
Okay, let's have the tally here. Three matches on this last question at $50 each. An additional $150, and so for this game, you end up with $250 for the Girl Scouts. Congratulations, ladies. All right, if you're all set, we'll plow on ahead to game number two. Boy, this is real competition between these two teams, isn't it? Ready? Here is your first question. Name an electrical device you would find in the bedroom. An electrical device you would find in the bedroom. Peggy's the first one finished. All right, hands down. Let's begin with Peggy. You were the first one finished, Peggy. What is your name?
Blanket.
Electric blanket. Betty, what do you say?
Blanket.
Blanket is a match. Now you're on the scoreboard.
You're right. I
Joan has a lamp. So there was one match there. Over to the gentleman now. Bennett, what have you got?
I have blanket.
Blanket. Henry? Electric what?
Radio.
A radio is an electrical device, yes. Bob? What electrical device
music
might
lover.
One find in the bedroom in your...
Just... Blanket!
A blanket, and that's a match. So the score is tied. Next question in a moment. Now, all tied up here, 25 all. And let's we're in game go. Number two. Let's see who wins this, if the either does. Fill in this blank. Duke blank. D-U-K-E is a word I'm giving you, and there's a blank afterward. Remember the rule. It can be a word or more than one word. Your judgment on how to match your teammates. Okay, hands down. Bennett is first this time.
A great music and star, Duke Ellington.
Duke Ellington. And Henry?
Oh, Henry, we're going to get you.
What do you say?
Another great musician, Duke Snyder.
Duke Snyder. And Robert, thank you.
There's one on every team. Yeah. Duke Ellington.
Ellington is a man. Now the gentlemen have 50 points altogether. Peggy, Duke, what? Duke.
My two teammates seem so worried. Ellington.
Duke Ellington, yes. Betty, what do you
one
think?
One of your teammates is worried. Duke of Windsor.
Duke of Windsor. Well, Joan?
Duke Wayne.
Duke Wayne.
Wayne.
Yeah. Well, there's no match for the ladies, so that means the gentleman have forged ahead a little bit. 50 to 25.
Oh, dear.
Now, write down one of the words in the song, row, row, row your boat, other than row, row, row your boat. No help from the audience. Write down one word in the song, row, row, row your boat, other than the words row, row, row your boat.
If I'm wrong, you'll hit me.
You're darn right.
All right, hands down. Let's see what word you chose. Peggy?
Stream.
Stream, she said.
Gently down the stream.
Yeah, sing the whole thing if you like, Peg. Betty?
Gently down the stream.
Gently down the stream. Joan?
Gently.
Gently is a man. Now, the score is tied at this moment. Let's complete the round and see if the gentleman untie it. Bennett.
I can't sing it as well, but I had stream. To...
Stream? Henry?
The pains are coming back.
They are.
J.
gently.
Gently is his answer. Now, Robert Q, you can forge
it. Smile, Henry.
So when you smile, smile.
Darn, just smile.
He's got gently, and there's a man. Ready? 75 to 50, either one could win. Name something people do to show their disapproval of a performance. Name something people do to show their disapproval of a performance. Please, don't do that up there. Okay, let's see what you've named. Peggy.
Boo.
Boo, she says very emphatically. Betty says,
boo,
boo is a man. Now, Joan.
Boo, boo, boo.
Boo is a match all the way across.
Okay.
Once again, gentlemen, one match to tie it, two to win it. Bennett.
I have hiss.
Oh.
Hiss. Good for you.
Peggy says good for you. Henry. He's got boo, so we have a hiss and a boo. And... Bob.
I said boo.
Boo is the match in the scores tie. All right, hissing and booing are the two common things. All tied up 100 all. Now name something that might be opened and shut. Name something that might be opened and shut. You want to change, Peg?
No, I don't.
All right. Ladies have finished, so they may put their hands down. Gentlemen have finished, they may put their hands down. And Bennett Cerf is first.
Door.
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 Door. Door.
All right, ladies, your work is cut out for you. You've got to match all the way across or the gentleman will win. Peggy.
Door.
Door. Betty.
Door.
Door. Joan, you've got to say door. They're going to win it. She's crying.
Open shut case.
Good
shot.
Open shut case. Betty and Joan win the game. All right.
We don't care.
Okay. You've got $150 on behalf of the Boy Scouts. Let's see how much time we have for the audience match questions of December 9th. These are the regular ones. And here's number one. $50, remember, for every correct answer. How many books do you read a month? We put that question to the studio audience. And now you have to tell us what you think their response was. Bennett, in your judgment, what did the audience say?
I hope they said two.
Two. Henry?
I can do better than that. I can do better than that. I got whole words here. one.
One. Bob?
I agree. Unfortunately, agree with Henry if they were being honest.
One, two, and two ones. All right. The answer from the audience was none. There's the whistle, and just in time for Bennett Cerf, because a little harakiri was about to be committed here as a publisher. We'll get back. Now, let's see how we did on behalf of the Girl Scouts and the Boy Scouts, beginning with the ladies and the Girl Scouts, therefore. Ladies, today, for the Girl Scouts, you won $250. So far, altogether, you've got $450, which you have won for them. And we'll look forward to seeing you here tomorrow. Now, over to the gentlemen's side, where, let's see, $150 today, plus what they did yesterday, $500 for the Boy Scouts so far. Very neat. Okay, join us here tomorrow for another session here of All-Star Match Day.